What's up, YouTube? In this episode, I'm gonna be going through different ways to pay your suppliers in China. Have you ever been in a situation where you found a really good deal from a supplier in China? They're like, yep, the final price is 1,000 RMB. But when it comes time to pay, they don't accept your payment method. And you're like, man, I can't get this deal. They don't accept my Visa or MasterCard. They only accept Alipay. They only accept WeChat Pay, whatever it may be. Well, I hope that in this video, I can show you the different methods you can pay your suppliers directly. Stay tuned. Now, in this video, I'm gonna cover four different ways that you can pay your supplier from the least riskiest to the most riskiest. And I'll go into detail what I mean by what is risky. So the first method I recommend is to use already established platforms like Taobao, 168, Alibaba, AliExpress, such as these that already have a platform to receive payments and give to your suppliers directly. This is the least risky because there's actually a system in place to track your order. So after you make a purchase, you get some kind of a receipt and then it tells you where it's at in the logistics process, whether it's being manufactured, whether it's being processed, whether it's already shipped, and whether it's already arrived at its final destination. These platforms also help weed out any sketchy or scammy sellers or suppliers, where people can leave reviews if they're good suppliers, bad suppliers, scammers, where you pay them and then they don't give you what they advertise. All these kind of things you can see in the platform, so it's the least risky. However, on the downside, to be able to pay them on the platform, you're gonna need an Alipay, whether it's a verified one with a Chinese bank account, or a tour pass, which I'll look in video up here on how to set up a tour pass, which you don't need a Chinese bank account for, but there are limitations where you can only buy 6,000 RMB worth of goods on a tour pass alone. But if you already have an established Alipay account that's verified and connected to your Chinese bank account, this is the way I prefer to do the transactions here in China. But there are others to help you out if you can't get a Chinese bank account, for example. The second most convenient method to pay your suppliers, but a little bit more risky, is directly through Alipay or WeChat. You can add them on WeChat and Alipay, and you know that they're a supplier because maybe on Taobao 168, you looked up the company, you were able to get their WeChat ID and to continue to converse with them and maybe try and negotiate some prices. Now, it's still possible to pay them. As I mentioned, the first method, if you have an Alipay tour pass, you don't need a Chinese bank account, but if you do have a Chinese bank account and maybe you want the pricing to be negotiated a little bit lower, you can pay them directly using Alipay or WeChat. You just add them as a friend and then you send them the money and you're good to go. However, something to note, it is a little bit more risky when you do it this way because there's no confirmed receipt of the payments and there's no like system to track the payment after you've paid. So it's more risky for the buyer. So just know that I would recommend this method only and only if you actually know the supplier, they're legit, or a friend of a friend that can verify they're a legit supplier, not just trying to scam you out of money, should you pay them directly using Alipay or WeChat. You may even have a friend that has an Alipay account that's willing to pay for you if you pay them in USD or some other form. The third method to pay your suppliers is through PayPal. Now, Taobao and 168 usually won't accept payments in PayPal, but if you contact a supplier on the website and you figure out what their PayPal email is, as long as they have a Chinese PayPal account that's linked to the Chinese bank account, you should be able to pay them. Actually, they can actually send you an invoice if they have your email address on your PayPal for the transaction you want to complete. So if I want to buy something for 100 USD worth an RMB, maybe like 700 RMB, they can bill you 700 RMB by requesting you to send the money. And then there's an invoice and a tracking system in place. So it's not as risky as you may seem. And you can track the order as it goes. One of the downsides of PayPal is that you can get feed more than one time. I guess that's a word, feed. The fees are just large. So the first fee would be the exchange rate. So if your account is in USD and their account is in RMB, the exchange rate to get the USD to RMB is gonna be more than what it's actually worth in the market. And then there's the actual PayPal transaction fee, which is maybe like 10% or 3%. It really depends on the amount and the type of service you're requiring from the supplier. But anyways, PayPal is also available. I recommend using PayPal if you already use PayPal in the United States or as internationally, because it's very convenient and it's easy to track the purchase because you can add a shipping number or a tracking number and you can even confirm receipt. And the supplier may not receive the funds until you've actually received the goods. and they usually put it on hold for 3 to 4 weeks, depending on how stable the account is. And the fourth method to pay your suppliers, which is probably gonna apply to most of you, because you don't have a Chinese bank account, you don't know someone who has a Chinese bank account, you don't have a verified Alipay address, you don't wanna do anything with PayPal or anything like that, are third-party platforms that specialize in transferring money. Just to name a few, I'll give you some examples. You have TransferWise, you have Western Union, you have MoneyGram, and possibly you have others there as well. So starting with TransferWise, this is actually a method I've been using to get money from outside of China into China. It doesn't work the other way around, unfortunately. But what you need to have is a linked bank account to your TransferWise account. So you just make an account, make sure it's linked to your home country's bank account, whether it's in the US or anywhere around the world. Once you have that linked, then you can make a request to send money from the currency you have to RMB into the person's bank account. The information you'll need from the person is their full name, maybe their ID card if they ask, they shouldn't, and their bank account number. Something you should know is that before you transfer money, I recommend you trying with a small amount just to make sure the transaction goes all the way through. But TransferWise will handle foreign currencies all the way to RMB. There will be fees, of course, involved. And then the supplier can receive the money directly into bank account. So that's how you would use TransferWise. The next one is Western Union. This is also a very popular way to send money from outside of China into China directly to your supplier's hands. There's two ways to do this, and it differs based on the country you're living in. So for example, I know someone from the Philippines that they can use the application on Western Union that's directly tied to their bank accounts and send the money into the Chinese supplier's bank account directly. All they will need is to provide maybe their passport, their personal passport information, their bank information linked to the Western Union. And for the receiver, they will need to provide their full name, maybe their phone number, email, and their bank account number, and it should go directly into that account within 2 to 3 days. Very convenient. Western Union in some countries also provides exchange services. So if you pay in USD, they can transfer it to RMB for a fee. There's another method of using Western Union, a little bit more old school, but also possible. You just Google Western Union and find your closest agency you can on Western Union. You go in there in person, go in there with your passport, maybe evidence of where you got the money from, and pay them in cash. So if I need to send $1,000 into someone's account into China, you can go ahead, give them $1,000 on the spot. You have the person's information, like their first name, last name, maybe their passport ID number, their phone number, all that. They can go ahead and send the money to them. If they don't have an account in China, but you still want them to send the money in China, it's also possible to do this, but it's a little bit more risky. You would do the exact same thing, either through the application or directly in the agency and say, I want to send this amount of money to this person. They don't have a bank account. That's okay. You just tell them the situation. But at a minimum, you'll need their name, passport, their ID card number, whether it's on their passport or their ID, and their phone number. Then that person will need to go to Western Union sponsored area, whether it's in an official office or a bank that works with Western Union, like ICBC or ABC in China. And you just say, my friend sent me money a couple days ago on Western Union. Here's the receipt and the order number. Then they'll look at the receipt and they'll look at the order and they'll check your ID card with their information. If you put your first, last name, your ID card number and all that, then they'll hand you the cash at the Western Union place. Now, it's a little bit old school, but it's a method that you can pay your supplier. Then you have MoneyGram, which is pretty much the exact same as Western Union. You can either link it directly to your bank account and send it into China, into their bank account, or they'll receive the cash either at the MoneyGram branch or maybe in their banks directly. Now, a couple of words of caution if you're using this method. There's no way to track the order of the actual supplies. So if you send the money to the person, there's no way in the system saying, oh, I already purchased the goods because I sent you the money. It's a little bit more risky here. You got to actually trust the supplier or the agent or friend you're sending the money to pay the supplier. So there's still one more step that needs to be done to pay the supplier. What I'd recommend is that you find a friend in China, pay them on Western Union. They use that money to pay a supplier on Taobao, so at least it's on record that they bought the item and they can't just run away with your money. Every country has different restrictions. I know some countries in Africa have some restrictions in using Western Union and MoneyGram, and there may be a limit in the transaction amount of how much they can send overseas or how much they can receive overseas. But I'm just letting you know, this is a very popular method used especially in like Congo, and sometimes in South Africa to send money overseas. So I just listed four ways to send money overseas. Don't worry, I'll put all this information in the description down below in case you need to look it up on your own and research which one best fits your situation. I have personally used all of these and have tested it out, but again, I'm from the United States and the restrictions may be a little bit different than from your country. But I just want to share this video because in the event you don't have a Chinese bank account, you can still get supplies in China with your own payment method and still continue running business, especially during this period of time. If you learned something from this video, please smash that like button and consider subscribing if you want to see more content about having a better lifestyle in China as a foreigner, whether it be here for visiting or for business. I'm starting a project with some of my subscribers where they can shop on 1688 or Taobao using most of the payment methods accepted worldwide. If you want to be a part of this project, feel free to follow me on social media or message me directly on social media. You can also leave a comment down below about any problems you may have and I can try and solve them for you. And if you need any one-on-one consultation or help that you may not be able to reach me, maybe on the YouTube comments or social media, feel free to join this WeChat group that I created where I provide updates about stuff that's going on in China and some information, or at least get you to the right resources that can help you do business or to live in China peacefully. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. Keep surviving, and I'll catch you in the next one.